load has been discussed by our from the industry side, from institution and entrepreneurship institutions, also from academia and ministry side. Dr. Saxena, we have Dr. N.P. Singh, my senior, who has been guiding me. It's very important to have skill development in all spheres of industrial development, and renewable energy is more important in the sense that we don't have the already existing infrastructure or the specialization in the field of renewable energy. Dr. Usha was talking about the IREP. That time the skill development was to develop skilled people who are ITI or unemployed diploma holders in rural areas, who can be trained to meet the needs of implementation of the integrated rural energy program. That system we were distributing in different rural areas. If anything goes wrong, who will repair them, who will maintain them, and how that program will be implemented in that sense. And now the role of renewable energy has become very much visible, and about 40 to 42 institutions are already awarding degrees. My experience is also there, like in Tejpur Central University, we started the first this master's degree. First we started diploma, and along with that the M.Tech in renewable energy. And many agriculture universities, institutions they have. In Allahabad also we started M.Tech in renewable energy. But it's very few programs are there. We want these programs to be at a larger scale, means each institution should have. Because now the contribution and the share of renewable energy is 13%. It will be 17% by 2017. And further will go 1,75,000, this ambitious target to meet that. We require huge manpower to implement those programs. Even from the industry side, people, they don't find skilled people. Who will manage the projects, who will implement the projects, who will maintain the projects. For that, at a larger scale, we require people. So here, no single individual can do the job. Although from our ministry side, now we have gone into very much specialization rather than talking renewable energy as such. We have decided that bioenergy has a different background, different type of knowledge, and different type of skill development and research is required in bioenergy. Similarly, in wind energy and the solar energy, they cannot be merged together because the background knowledge is different, and the research background should also be different for different resources. So our ministry has already established all the three institutions: National Institute of Solar Energy in Gurgaon, National Institute of Wind Energy in Chennai, and my institute, that is National Institute of Renewable Energy. Now we are a National Institute of Bioenergy. So we want to go in that very much specialized working in this area, and with a quality output. I mean, it's not just we give a superficial knowledge and just repair and maintenance. No, they have to execute the project, so we will train the people to that level. And skill development has to be done at all levels. Academia, yes, we require. If we don't have the teachers, how the students will be prepared? But at the same time, we require the engineers also. We don't have special program in engineering, so we will add some components in the relevant branches where people they are trained. Maybe the last semester we can give projects from renewable energy institutions, and then the engineer is trained, specialized in this, because flexible system is coming, and there we have the scope that in 6 months we can give. So we have developed module also, course curriculum for ITI, diploma holders and degree holders. In bioenergy we have developed, in solar energy we have developed. It's just a humble beginning, and if we work together, I think we will be able to meet the challenges. But it will not be 20 have been trained or 50 have been trained. We will have to talk in millions and billions. And that type of skill development has to be done in the country to meet the target of the renewable energy installation in the country. And in bioenergy session also, we'll be speaking more, Dr. Saxena.
Thank you very much.